Warning! All the clips in this video do not belong to me. All rights go respectfully to Lucasfilm and Disney. Thank you. Please don't block this video. Thank you. Now, let's start.
Hello there! This is Alparantesis!
About a week or two ago, the digital version of The Last Jedi came out. Although I didn't have the chance to buy it, because I'm from Russia and it's very hard here, I did find a full-length documentary from the disc about how the film was made, and I watched it on YouTube. And now I really enjoyed this one, and I really wanted to talk a lot about the parts I really liked and discuss them with you. This is Alparantesis, and these are my basically favorite parts of the documentary of the director and the Jedi from The Last Jedi. Let's begin! In the beginning, the documentary has a very interesting part about how they were testing the BB-8 robot. It is very incredible. I mean, I never thought a robot like a real one could actually move like that. I thought they only used sort of hand-controlled puppets and everything and CGI and everything, but some of the scenes, as I can see from this part of the documentary, in fact, I think most of them were filmed with this actual robot who moved in that actual way, and For me, at first, it seemed impossible, but now I can certainly see that there is a way to how this could be made. After that, there is a scene of how they shot the fight between Rey and Luke. There is nothing really extraordinary here. The water is just like an Attack of the Clones, sprayed over the actors' bodies. But why I found this amazing is the fact that it's very, very, and at least here, it seems to be very light. Like, the lightness of the actual set seems like it's daytime, when in the movie it is completely different and dark. Now, this may be just a training session, but it seems like they're already filming. And maybe it's just me, but this seems too sort of light for my taste. And I think maybe it's just that they edited the darkness after that to kind of make it a bit darker. I don't know, but it's interesting. But in this clip from the same documentary, this actually seems much, much sort of darker. So maybe they, it was just, I don't know. Maybe I just, it just mine. Okay, let's go on to the next thing. Now the next scene is Warwick Davis, a traditional Star Wars actor, dressing into the suit of his character. Now, this part was completely sort of deleted from the movie, but it was part of the extended 5-year chase where he was in a bath, basically in a sauna, and he was naked. This part was deleted, however, it was filmed and Warwick Davis was inside that costume. So it's pretty cool seeing also all those creatures and puppets and everything that didn't end up in the film. We also see Frank Oz, Yoda's original puppeteer and voice in all of the movies, return as Yoda. Mark Hamill gets quite emotional seeing how they recreated the puppet and how similar it was to the original, although not so much in the film as from the angles it was shot. However, it does look even like it looks better when it's not in the film but in the documentary, with Frank Oz under it and he's hugging with Mark Hamill and it's so sweet. And he's once again providing the voice. In fact, Frank Oz in this documentary said that at first he thought it would be just CGI and him providing the voice. However, he was later told that they were going to make an entire puppet and that was much, much harder to create. It was also cool seeing the combination of all the techniques that went in to create the 5 years. such as being robotics, puppets, animatronics, CGI, green screens, everything. With the puppeteers, with everyone just working to sort of create this creature and bring it to life on screen, with the people sitting behind them and sort of controlling their eyes and everything. And it's just amazing, and it looks visually stunning, every single bit of it. I really enjoyed those parts of the documentary.
I was also surprised to see how much practical work went into the movie, such as all the explosions with the stunt doubles being inside, and a lot of the creatures being just controlled from behind. It really shows how in this point in time we can create anything we want, but sometimes without even like CGI, well, involving CGI, but not doing completely. And I think that's really cool. I also enjoyed this moment in the documentary when the actors of Finn and Rose couldn't understand if this was a creature created by the puppeteers or if it was an actual actor in a mask. Because the same happened with me, I was totally confused. That's how they mixed everything in so damn impressive. Speaking of blending in CGI and practical elements, I was completely surprised that the parts of Snoke's body after he was cut down were not CGI, but actual sort of parts, because they looked really realistic. And I thought it was just an addition by the CGI artist, but no, it was behind Rey and Kylo, Adam Driver and Daisy Ridley, when they fought the Praetorian guards on the set. It was behind them and it looked totally good, real, and realistic. Another part I was amazed with the practical effects was Luke's stunt double jumping through actual skills of Skellig Michael. I mean, it's incredible. I mean, I thought maybe they'd do it in a set, if not on a green screen, but on the actual island in the weather, it's incredible. It's fascinating. Then, of course, I forgot their name, the creatures with the green milk that Luke milked in the movie. They were done practically too. This is the last thing I will be mentioning, but they were basically enormous puppets that were set again on the island, not on a set, not anywhere. They carried those enormous things, like, I don't know, maybe on a helicopter, or maybe they folded them, but they were using them as puppets and moving them like they were moving them with special sticks that were sort of in the different parts of the creature, and then the people behind in blue screen suits were just like moving the sticks, and then the sticks and the people were deleted from the frame as if all the movements were done by the actual creatures in the actual shot. And yeah, thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this. Operansis out.